Previously on the Reckoning series. The 2012 season doesn't go as planned, and Dynasty has a disappointing finish nearly every event.
We were just dumbfounded. I don't even think Hinman came down on us because he was just like, whoa, what happened too, you know?
That was a bad call, the guy that ran through over here. I mean, you know what
they are. Yeah, but those are the dude, in a pro game, but hey, but those are the, that doesn't need to be said.
I think the team put a lot of the responsibility on some bad calls rather than putting the responsibility on ourselves.
Fucking stay alive and we'll win! We're up every game!
Really frustrating, man, staying out there when we're up bodies and we just fucking give them back!
Toward the end of the year, Mike Hinman leaves the team to coach the Ironmen, and Rusty Glaze steps up as the new coach. The team saw immediate success with a win at the Las Vegas NPPL, but then had a disappointing finish at World Cup.
It was definitely a hard year, and I think there was a lot of maturing that had to happen for us to come back like we did at the end of the year, and I think there's only an upside ahead of us.
They came up to us. We lend out our hand. They spit in your face. This is your promised land. Hey, hey, where did survival go? We saw them pack up their bags and watched their harder body go. We're all dead men here after all. We're all dead men here after all. Got time to kill, got time to spare. We're all dead men here after all. We're all dead men here after all. Always here to lend a dying hand.
During the offseason, both Mike Mesa and Ray Almada leave the team, leaving spots open for new talent to come in.
So this season we picked up Kyle Spicka, Brandon Short, and we just picked up Tyler Harmon as kind of a late addition. Brandon Short has definitely been around the rosy, won championships. Kyle Spicka's improving, super quick, super nice guy and hungry, and Tyler Harmon's also a veteran, but he's 23 years old.
He was really willing to play, really hungry, and all he wanted to do was just try out. You know, he's like, I'll do whatever I can. I'll pay for my own way down there. I just want to show you guys that I'm ready to play at the high level. And then, unfortunately, Brandon broke his hand at practice, which also helped for Tyler's sake. And we're like, you know what, we'll bring Tyler to replace Brandon for now.
It's always been a dream of mine since I was like 11 years old to play for this team. So naturally, I gravitated towards them once I wanted to play in the PSP. I had some other options, but I knew where I wanted to be.
The team's gelling pretty well with the new players. Obviously, that always takes time to get the new guys in the groove, but they're already so experienced that I think they're going to be able to hold their own right off the bat. You know how there's sometimes that guy on the team that you're like, man, I don't want a roommate with that guy. You know, like right now, currently, we don't have any guys like that, so.
For us, coming into Dallas, we just want to, you know, play as hard as we can, work together, and hopefully win every game and win the tournament. And that's what it's really all about. If you're not coming out to win, then you might as well stay home.
Their first match of the season is against Sacramento Excessive.
Hey, listen, okay? Together we're gonna do this shit, not by ourselves, all right? Together. Believe in yourself, believe in your team, and let's go out and do this shit.
Hell yeah,
we
man.
Know how to do this, believe it, let's go!
D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y-N-I-F-D-Y
First match of the tournament, first match of the year, nothing was going to be easy. So we got fired up, you know, and we went out there and won the first point. I believe we got a penalty and ended up having to play the second point 4-on-5. And I think that was the only penalty point we lost the entire tournament.
Tyler's a character, man. He's got some great moves up his sleeve and jumped over the snake. You know, he's running over there. I don't know if that was his game plan. Like, I'm gonna jump over the snake and I'm gonna shoot him one-handed. We actually nicknamed him after that Mantis. Yeah, because he's like a praying mantis. He's super tall. He's got really long, lanky arms, and he's just flying around, just ripping people apart.
Missed me, boy.
This is important.
This is where you don't let the fuck
yeah.
up.
Yeah, Glenn's absolutely right.
Yes.
We get up 5-1, we think no matter what, we're going to win the match, and we fucking slip points,
play
man.
Harder. Let's
yeah.
go.
Yeah.
Play harder.
Harder, man. That's it.
Let's go.
Let's go.
A lot of teams have this mistake is
is they played a certain way. We played a certain way to get to 5-1. Why would we not continue to play that way with that intensity? You can't make the assumption because you're up that you're just going to win the game. The game ends at 7, and that's kind of what I say to the guys when we get up is I remind them, let's finish this game.
Rusty says, every time we step on the field, there's a team that's trying to beat the shit out of us. You know, we got to take that personally. We got to come out swinging, even if we have a big lead. It was easy to keep the pace. You know, everybody was fired up. Things were intense. And, yeah, it was easy to follow orders.
After a convincing 7-1 win over Excessive, the team's next match is against Houston Heat.
The thing about Heat is they're the reigning champs from last year. So coming into that game, we knew that it wasn't going to be like the Excessive game. We went up on them and we kind of gave them back a couple points. Now we're the team that has to fight back and change what we were doing, because what we were doing to begin with was working. And then they figured it out, they changed it up, and then now they're winning. So now we have to readjust what we're doing. So it's like it's a back and forth kind of mind game as far as figuring out what to do next. Colin got a couple minors. I don't know what they were for, but Glenn was running to the spot when he saw me get pulled out, and then we bumped into each other. Did Glenn get shot out right then? Whoops. Sorry, Glenn.
We're in that driving position. We got to stay on top of it and not make mistakes. I think Fedorov had 17 kills against us. I mean, he had a monster game. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! There was just points that came down to mental mistakes that we made. Dalton made a weird move on the Dorito side where he came in channel. Instead of going down the Dorito side, he got shot, opened up that side, just doing unstandard things.
Came down to that last, you know, little bit. It was such a quick point, and I think that it came down to there was one guy left. Mishka was the last guy alive. We just didn't have enough time to pull it out.
Let's just talk, hey, real quick. Hey, we put ourselves in that position. There was points where we could have used teamwork a little better. We were up bodies. Two of them that we threw away, where we were up two bodies or more that we just gave back to them. It would have been them running down the field at us, because we would have been up those points. They would have been down those points. So the fact that we didn't hang within seconds, yes, we fought hard and we fucking had great effort in the end. But we don't want to be in that position, man. We want to be in the position where we're standing strong and those guys have to do crazy shit. We want to avoid the go play. So let's fucking, it's a tough match.
Gotta clean it up for tomorrow.
Those intense points, every point, man.
Yep. Put it together.
That's what's up. Hey, tonight we'll be on the. Hey, tonight we're on the projector. We're doing homework. That's it. No long dinner.
That's right.
We gotta eat fast and we gotta do our homework. Yeah.
I fucking trust every single one of you motherfuckers. We're gonna win this.
We got this.
Let's go, baby.
Let's go, man.
Let's go. Team on three. 1, 2, 3.
Adjustment off losing the corner, so we know we shoot a corner, guys.
They still want the corner.
Then once they did that little weird move, they came back out to the corner.
Dude, I don't know.
They're putting a lot inside. You get this little map, and then you have 10 guys that are all trying to look at this tiny little map, and like three guys are putting their fingers on it and doing stuff, and the other 8 guys can't see the map. It's either got to be turned the right way for them, or I don't know, I just got sick of it. Well, most sports teams, when they sit in like a classroom setting, they watch film and they look at something that's on the wall, and everyone's facing one direction. It's kind of made sense to me, so I brought a projector and it's gave us better focus. So that night we looked over X Factors, breakouts, some of their game plans, and we just try and pick apart 5 things we can take into the next match.
Look, tomorrow we want to fucking shoot the snake side corner.
Yeah, right? More importantly,
that's where they want to get to.
And I got Spica has to stay alive. Like Spica has to do it. He can't go into the snake and try to push it. He's got to stay alive. Otherwise, they're swinging around that side.
That's a lesson everyone needs to take in. You're a front guy, you don't have to win the point yourself. Dude, you easily look back and say, hey, Oliver,
where they at, whatever. Yeah. Oliver says, hey, I want to get weird. I'll come up to the queen next to you. I'll come up to the closet. Like, we can progress down the field with these guys. And then Dalton can stay channel, probably bunker those guys out or whatever.
Like, let's fucking pound these guys in the fucking ground, dude. Just keep shooting, dude.
We owe these motherfuckers one, too.
Bring extra paint and just keep shooting. Brandon said it best, man. We're not paying for this paint, dude.
Yeah, I carried three more extra paws than I ever used to.
All right, listen. No more mistakes. How about that? 1, 2, 3.
No.
1, 2, 3.
The biggest thing that looms over your head in a one-on-one day is we have to go 2-0 the next day. This league right now is so cutthroat that you can't afford to lose too much or any at all, really. A loss in the first day is rough, but it's a good learning curve. So we were able to pick it up and focus on the two games that we had.
Let's go, man. We have to win. Let's fucking stick some guys.
We have to.
Let's get some stars.
Hey, get some stars.
Get some triangles.
There, man.
Let's get some stars. Let's go.
Those guys knocked us out of World Cup. So I think as a team, we'll never forgive those guys. They could show up and be the worst team or show up and be the best team. So we just had to know, hey, let's go give it to these guys and do what we can do.
It looked like Colton was kind of oblivious to what was going on. You know, I'm sure he was in there immediately fishing for kills across the field, but Dalton got a handle on the situation real fast. And I mean, I know he got surprised.
And it was the type of field where you could get to spots safely. Everyone was just kind of sitting tight, you know, no one wanted to make a mistake. And eventually we ended up having to trade out on the Doritos. And at the same time, Alex ran down the field and he went down there, traded out with the guy, saw that the guy spun on him. And was probably like, well, that guy looked really bad, so if I take an extra step or two, you know, then it'll probably be okay. I'm sure the refs saw what that guy did, you know, whatever, you know, sometimes calls go your way, sometimes they don't, and that one may have gone our way.
Let's go, Dynasty! D-Y-N-A-S-T!
What?
Now let's get 5 more.
Arce is a great player, and if we know he's going to a certain spot, let's try to contain him, but I think in the third point he came down and just reminded us that we have to watch out for him. He used to play on our team. You know, we taught him everything he knows.
So the fourth point was a bit chaotic. Ultimately, Colt got to go down and hang the flag, and Alex ended up getting a major. Created a little bit of confusion for us in the pit because we couldn't see exactly what happened.
What's going on here?
No, what?
No, we realize that's a breaking point. If we can play super hard and we can win a penalty point, it'll deflate the other team because they're going to be coming on hard. Hey, they have a penalty. Let's try and rack up points. Let's go beat these guys. Why not? If you punch those guys right in the mouth, you won't really have a problem after that.
So we had that penalty. They were coming down to our side of the snake, so we knew one of their heads were down. And then I went up there, and I guess X-Factor's coach forgot to tell him that I was coming. That was great for me. Then I turned in and shot Cole. At that point, when all the commotion went down, Cole was the one watching over Scott. And then Yosh was able to play right off that, which was an awesome move. And then Glenn and I were able to finish off Grayson.
Hey, let's go, Dynasty!
Come on, drive the attention! Let's go!
Let's go!
Come on, man!
Rusty has gotten everybody to play at such a level that everyone's confident in everyone. You know, a guy getting a penalty, you can't go back and erase it. We weren't going to get pissed off about those things that were no longer in our control. I think that this was a big confidence booster. I mean, it really showed us that the stuff that we had been working on at practice and the stuff that we had talked about the night before was working. You know, we want to set this goal and we're going to do everything we can to attain the goal. That match started to show us that that was possible and that's the way it was going to be.
The majority of the time we play CEP, there's usually a penalty on their side. I think they scored 2 points in us in our history of playing, you know, so it's good to have them at the end because, you know, it's a bit of a buffer. And then we had the hard games in the middle, so we were able to learn from our mistakes, and then we were playing them, so it's kind of polishing off some of the moves and keeping things smooth.
After a successful second day, Dynasty goes 3-1 and moves into the quarterfinals. They will face off against the LA Ironmen.
I like playing the Ironmen not because I don't respect them, but because I know that that's probably our biggest rivalry. Mike Hinman used to coach us. We ended on pretty good terms, but it was obviously not a situation that was working out well for either party. So I'm sure he wanted to come out with his new group of guys and show us that it was that we were the problem and it wasn't him. And some of the guys on their team too, you know, we were practicing against each other all the time. And there's a big competitive feeling, you know, every weekend that we're out at Camp Pendleton. And, you know, we knew they were going to play us hard, but we just knew we had to play our game.
Came out and gave us a great run for our money. We went up on them, they came back. It was a really big back and forth battle.
I know, yeah. Hey, listen, all tournament, it doesn't matter, man. Whatever the chips lay, it doesn't matter. We just fucking play to win points on the board, yeah?
Now's the time. We got a major penalty. We can break these guys on this point. We can literally break these guys.
Let's fucking hammer them, man. We hammer them right here, it lights out. You take the wind out of their sails.
Felt like everything was going right, and in the overall scheme, you know, everything's not going right. I mean, it's a close game. We've only got two guys left on the Dorito side, but in that moment between Glenn and I, it felt like everything was going right. You know, we were having this little conversation. You know, I just got this little tingling feeling in the small of my lower back, and honestly, I just peeked out because it felt like it was the right thing to do, and Mouse was running straight at me. So that's really what turned the game around. Made a good move to come back across the field after we had shot out their Dorito side. He caught Oliver slipping. He made a good shot, and then we lost the point.
The point where we're tied up, and it came kind of stagnant, and I saw him move up the center and came over, jump over the snake, bunkered toke, broke all the paint in my loader, came up to try to shoot Mike Paxton across the field, and I heard the sidelines telling me that Spitz was coming to bunker me, so I turned and I was looking at him when he came to get me. It was a split second kind of thing. He for sure missed me with his first shot, I mean 100%, but I guess the refs thought it hit me first, but whatever. I got a major, Alex shot him, we won the point.
Leave, motherfuckers, all right? Right, they're gonna come to the center, all right? They're gonna go to the stake.
Right.
Let's go, they got nothing to lose.
No matter what happens, we fight for it, man.
Yeah, baby.
Sunday is all about one step at a time, you know, and beating the Ironman, that was a big step. So we were all happy. We were all excited to get to the next one. And, you know, it was easy for us to get refocused.
The team advances to the semifinals and will be up against LA Infamous.
Infamous is an interesting team to play. they're kind of a momentum-based team, so it's hard to judge what you're going to get. They're not like a calm team like Tampa where you know you're going to get consistency. It's hard to know what to expect.
Hey, I know everybody here wants it. Now we just got to get it.
Prove it.
Come on.
Listen, hey, dig fucking deep. That's all I got to say. Grit. That's the word for this year.
Let's go.
Fucking grit. And that's right now is what happens.
Oliver
right
came up with our slogan this year is grit, you know. We always want to win, and that's always in the back of our minds. But, you know, you really have to dig deep, and you really have to find what it takes inside, a lot more determination. And this year we've been practicing harder than everybody. I can say that for a fact. So they came to try to get me out of snake one. You know, I slipped in there. I think it was a 3-on-1 anyway, so I was pretty doomed as it was. But once I shot the first guy out of the snake, I was stoked and I was kind of repositioning myself and I knew where the guys were, but all of a sudden just one of those random balls bounced off the thing and hit me in the side of the goggles. So that was a huge bummer. I thought I might have had a chance there.
They had a pretty good game plan against us, and they came out and put up 3 points, went up 3-0. Drew played really good at the Dorito side. I think he ate up Dalton 3 or 4 times on that Dorito side by himself and was able to shoot out guys. So they were able to shoot a guy on our Dorito side on the break, and then they were able to come up that side pretty steady.
Lost Oliver.
Yeah, I know that, but then how Glenn died?
Glenn got held for the penalty.
I think some people were a little uncertain as to what was going on and why we were losing those points. But no one was yelling at each other. We weren't screaming. We weren't freaking out. Rusty's called the line out for the point four and was like, let's go back out there and you guys owe me 3 points.
Who's in the penalty? Dalt? Okay, so give me Alex, Glenn, Yosh, and Ryan.
Hey, let's go, man. We got to stack up.
So the fourth point, I saw the opening to go up the center. I was looking for him. I saw both of those guys kind of sitting heads up. One was in the little Dorito. Damien was in the tower. So I shot both of those guys, and then I knew exactly where Nikki was. So went up there, and I think that put a lot more steam in everybody's engines.
Big fucking point right here.
Hey, this is the point that we come back. Yeah. Let's go.
Teams come down from 5-0 and win a match, so you just got to keep that why not grit. Having that drive and intensity is what turns matches like this around.
Let's go, Dynasty! We're fucking back! Let's go!
I was in the snake. I looked up and I saw their corner guy wasn't looking at me, so I knew Callie was only a couple steps away from me. I took about one step and then I heard Rich Telford in the corner going, he's coming!
Hey, he's coming! That's a penalty!
Whoever was in the snake corner did a really good job, and Callie did a great job of tucking in completely to where I couldn't see him, and I got shot before I even made it to him, so I just kind of gave up. It's not like I missed him. I just didn't want to take any shots and risk a penalty.
We needed to win the point to tie the game up. We stayed in the point for a long period of time, but then it just came down to them shooting out our bodies, and then I was going for the horn. So we had 2 minutes to make 2 points. It wasn't that stressful because it wasn't like I'm out there like, who to put in. I know who to put in. I know who to put in for defense. I know who to put in on the go play. We have some, you know, fast go-getters.
Let's go, Dynasty!
We've seen teams run down the field in 10 seconds.
It's not really a stressful situation. It's kind of, you know, you live for these moments. Is why not? Can we do this?
When you start taking points back from a team that's ahead and there's not a lot of time left on the clock, I think you start taking away some of that belief that they're doing it, they're going to win, and you start putting this feeling of disbelief, like, is this really happening to us? You know, I don't know, it's starting to feel a little rocky now. I think that breeds poor decisions. And Callie getting a penalty at that point, it's not something that he typically would do. but I think it was all just part of that recipe, you know? Once you get the momentum on your side, then you keep pushing, you keep the pressure on, and you get guys to crack.
Let's go!
1 minute left.
Come on, let's get this
fucking point. We had momentum, so we got back out there, and same thing, let's go with the go play. At that point, we're trying to tie the match. You know, it's 50-something seconds left. We're just looking, hey, let's tie up the match and we can play these guys in overtime. The momentum's coming our way. It should work out for us.
We came out of the gates blazing. We knew who we could shoot. We shot their first guy on the snake side and then came down the field really quick, scored that point.
Put that same fucking grip.
Yeah!
Hey, let's go! Come on, Dynasty!
We tied the game up. There's 23 seconds left. Let's just go out there. Let's do the same game plan. So we shot those lanes the exact same way we did. We got a kill, and we got another quick kill, and everybody went off to the races.
And then one third, three, 3 points in fucking 2 minutes, man.
Yeah,
that's the driving intensity right there.
Yes. Hey, we're going to win. Hard,
when we go
man.
Out and we say, let's put a point on the board, let's get it, man.
Wow, motherfuckers, wow.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Do this shit for each other, boys.
Hey, we're here. We're here where we wanted to be all along. Now let's fucking take it. That's the next step.
Hey, we just saw that firsthand, real drip, okay? Now it's time to dig even deeper. Deeper. Let's fucking win.
Hey, we've been here. We know what to do. Let's take this and fucking finish, man.
Let's go, motherfuckers. D-Y-N-A-S-D. One, two, three,
team. Grit!
After that match and after the tournament, that was the match that people were talking about. And to hear that that was the most exciting match people had seen in the past 5 or 10 years, you know, it's a really cool thing to be a part of. And to be on the winning side of that and to get that boost and know that you're going to be able to continue with that momentum going into the final game, it's like that feeling. Everything's going in our favor, you know? Let's keep going. Let's rattle this out while things are on our side.
When you line up against Damage, I feel like I stalked them the whole event because you know they're a good team. So with Damage, it's like, okay, let me look over the maps and I got this game, this game, this game. I'm like, gee, I feel like I stalked these guys. Through that, you start to look at data and you start to say, okay, I'm starting to see the habits. When this guy comes on, he does this. When this guy comes on, he does that. So felt like we had enough pieces together that we could give some small advantages. But, you know, with them, you got to play hard the whole time. And we knew that was going to be a tough match.
We've come a long way to be right here. All right? Be right here, right now! Okay?
Yep, that's
right
it!
Here. Right now!
Right now!
Okay?
That's it, right now!
Is what fucking matters!
Yep!
So it's time, baby! It's time to start, Dynasty! It's time to fucking watch this!
Hey, man, all the practices got us here, man!
Yeah,
that's
go.
What
hey,
got hey, us hey. Here! It's all the hard work we've been doing! Every point led to this right now! Let's be right fucking now! Let's fucking play hard right now!
Let's go! D-Y-N-A-S-D! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1! 1
Usually as it comes to finals, all the points go long because teams aren't willing to make mistakes. Most final games, the first point's usually pretty long unless a lot of people die on the break.
I was really low on paint and I knew that Jason was on the other side also. I saw him move up over there. And I also saw Chad right in front of me. It was like such a hot, long point. And I was trying to like get up to go make a move on Chad right in front of me. And I just didn't have it. Slept on Jason over there.
lost a close point, but we talked about this. This is the way it's going to be. So pick it up, you know, go back out there. We owe Rusty 2 points. Let's make it happen.
Hey, Ryan, look for a snake on the break. Holiday's in. D-Y-N-A-S-T! It's right now, man. Every point's brand new.
Traded someone and left us in a 2-on-1. Blake gets shot, just looks inside, Jason hits him. Now it's all 1-on-1 with Yosh. I'm like, but you know, penalty box is coming out too. So not only is Yosh in a 1-on-1, but now he's gonna be in a 2-on-1.
He was making moves coming down the field. I think he was trying to put the pressure on me so that I couldn't like step out and try to shoot the box and re-even it back up. Playing against a guy like that, you know, he's a gunfighting maniac. He's really good at it, but I think he might have just extended himself a little bit too much. It came down to Keith and I. The pressure was on him as long as I could maintain where he was and keep my gun up, and I was just kind of watching the clock, watching the seconds tick off. I think he was trying to get creative and then just decided he was going to go for it. And when he went into a bad bunker, then I chose the firefight.
That's it, man. D-Y-N-A-S-T! That's it, man. You gotta believe and play fucking hard.
After we went up points, I knew that the ball was in our court because it put them out of their comfort zone. So when we're up points and they have to come at us, it's gonna be a little tougher for them.
Hey, Rusty, call the line, baby.
Don, Glenn, Oliver, Ryan, Spica.
That's a fucking good line. Let's go! Let's go, Dynasty!
It makes it tough on them to have penalties, especially against a team like us. But I thought we played a controlled game throughout the whole match.
Let's go! D-Y-N-A-S-T! Let's go all day!
They got a penalty!
Yes!
Hey, look, guys, we put points on the board. We don't hold people off. We put points on the board.
Yes.
Dynasty, we stay focused. We don't fucking let up.
We never let off that intensity that at any point we thought we had won the tournament. We made a 23-second point just in the round before. So why would we think someone else can't do that? For me, it's not over because I thought they would blow the horn and we'd go back out and I had to get another set of guys out. But then, you know, they kind of just let the time run off and accepted that, you know, we won the tournament.
Get up.
Yeah. Woo! We got this, man.
Yeah!
Hey, I'm here. Fuck yeah, man. Fuck yeah.
Pop your cherry, baby. I told you we would.
Fuck yeah, man.
I personally was stoked on that win just because I knew that everybody put a lot into the event. And I was stoked to see some of the guys like Tyler and Spica, who never really won a big pro event before. You know, Brandon, the first time, you know, he was coaching on the sidelines, but he was still every bit a part of it. And all the other guys were so stoked. There was a lot of people who were really skeptical about the team. And it's always good to make sure that show everybody that we're still pretty good. We still got it.
How does it feel to take a fucking bath in the fountain of youth, baby?
Yeah! Yeah!
That fucking fountain was pretty.
All the hard work, man. Let's go.
This is what it's about. It's all the hard work.
Hell yeah, baby. Right.
baby. Woo! I just love seeing your motherfucking faces like this. I want more.
Let's go.
More and more. I don't want to stop. I want to keep working hard.
I'm over here now.
I keep fucking.
Come on.
Yeah, baby. That was just an appetizer.
Ah.
Let's go. On DYNAS.
One. One. One.
Fucking winner. Winner. One. Two. Three. Three.
The feeling of winning after playing the tournament like we had played it, having so many close games, getting penalties and coming back, having to go after the first day and re-examine what we're doing, you know, being 1-1, is the big payoff. And it was important for the guys that were on the team last year to understand that last year wasn't a fluke, but it was a product of not having the right things going on. Nothing's easy, and we changed some things up and we refocused. I think we found our formula. Let's stick to it. This is working. This feels great. I don't want to stop doing this.
After Dallas, the team heads to Huntington Beach, California for the NPPL Surf City Open. Brandon Short is now back from his injury, and Andy Horvath will be playing with the team for this event.
He was coming off a knee injury. We brought him to Dallas, and he sideline coached for us. He got his knee back to 100%. I told him, hey, here's the deal. You got to come out to practice. You got to shoot people. You got to fill the role that we need, and we'll line you up and put you on. I'm an equal opportunity coach. He came out to the practice. He filled in a good role in the snake corner. He communicated well and closed out games well for us, and we put him on the roster for 7-8.
We came out in the prelims in Huntington Beach, and it was, for lack of a better term, it was easier than we would have wanted. Like, it was kind of like playing these pickup games at Camp Pendleton on the practice weekends.
I think we went 16-0. We won 16 straight points. I mean, we didn't lose any points. That can be a problem.
Let's work together. Let's do this shit. It's not that simple when we do this together. Do I have to do it? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 2. Woo! Brent, let's go!
Working so well for us that it was kind of hard to get an assessment as far as what we were doing wrong and what we were doing right.
After that Saturday night, we went to like a promo dinner. We got a free dinner and we did an appearance thing for the league. Then we went to Artifact video premiere thing and watch the video of HB's history. We didn't get the same get together as a team, break down the problems of what we did against Uprising, what we need to do. We just didn't have time. It was just, we went to these events or whatever. I think people felt confident. We went 16-0.
We had played Uprising in the prelims, the last game, and to be totally honest, they probably deserved to win a couple more of those points than they did, and they may have ended up taking that match, but they got a shit ton of penalties. And I'm not saying they didn't deserve them, but their game plan and the way they played was probably better than the way we played in the prelims. So when we went into our game planning for the semifinals match on Sunday morning, we weren't taking them lightly, and it was time to game plan against a really good team.
It's like a little secret, I guess now, the secret's that the jig's up now, but you play on that really slippery turf. If you put socks over your shoes, you get a better grip. I don't know how exactly it works, but we learned that in Vegas.
We kind of had a morning meeting. We went over certain things, and you know, I think some mistakes were made in the planning, and we just didn't position ourselves to take advantage of what we could have.
These guys know if they try to fucking play us, they're gonna lose, okay? We can't afford to die like this. That's it. Yeah.
think we put a little too much emphasis on Mouse trying to shoot him out. All the other games that we played, we'd shoot one or two guys off that side every time. But for some reason, we couldn't hit that fucker. So we put a little too much emphasis on him, and it didn't end up working out in our favor.
Was winding down, so I think we had a minute and something to tie up the match.
We're gonna fucking play to win it, okay? Alright? I think we're gonna fucking win, and then we're gonna go and play 3-on-3. So get your heads up, let's fucking go.
Alright, just touch down the caliber. We got the people. We got
the sex people. The sex people. Okay.
Side of the snake when Oliver made a move. Oliver and Mouse ran around the bunker at each other. I shot Mouse, and then I ran up and shot Dave. I was standing behind him in the corner when everybody was yelling, and I saw a flag go up in the air, so I just assumed that it was on them because Mouse was running around in circles. Dave had hits on him, Oliver had hits on him, and I was waving like, hey, what about me? Like, I'm shooting these guys, and they're like, no, you guys got the penalty. Game over. It was like, I think that there was a lot of confusion because it was such a quick thing that happened. I thought the penalty was on them. The refs obviously threw the penalty on Oliver, and it was a pretty frustrating loss.
Yeah, I saw what you were doing.
Hey,
what
happened to you two?
Yeah, motherfuck you, dude.
You're right, man.
Fucking 10 seconds, we're fucking coming through.
After that point, people weren't really at each other's throats except for Ryan and Oliver. Ryan, Oliver, Alex, and I have this really long history together. And for the longest time, it was always Ryan and I against Alex and Oliver, just because that's how we grew up. Oliver was pissed. He felt like I was taking Ryan's side when really that wasn't what was going on.
Kind of like made everyone realize, hey, just because we win a tournament doesn't mean everyone's going to roll over for us. So yeah, back to the grinding stone and back to long, long days in practice. There's no luxury.
A week before the MAO event, Dynasty has a two-day practice with the LA Ironmen at Camp Pendleton.
Saturday and took a beating. I mean, brutal beating. I track all the points and they beat us 20-5 score-wise. So we're driving home from practice. Light bulb goes off. I call Yosh on the phone. I go, dude, I got it.
Rusty called me on the drive home and he was like, Yosh, I got it. I got the plan, man. We're going to beat him tomorrow. Don't worry. You know, I've got it figured out. And we showed up Sunday morning. We talked about it as a team. We talked about it for like 30 minutes because we wanted to make sure everyone was on the same page. We're just going to sit there. We're going to run to the five closest spots. We're not going to make any moves. We're going to play like we're playing. It's a penalty point. And we're just trying to stay alive and kill the time. And it's going to frustrate them. And eventually they're going to get so frustrated, they're going to break. And ultimately that's what happened. We won the first 3 points. They were probably 7 to 10 minutes each. And we won the first 3 points and we could tell they were frustrated. And they ended up coming back and winning some points. But at the end of the day, I think we played 10 points. And they went home because they said, we're not learning anything from you guys. They left, we stuck around for another 5 hours, did drills, reinforced some of the good things that were happening that day, and ended up having a really great practice.
Coming off a disappointing loss at Huntington Beach, the team is looking to come back strong and hold their title in the PSP. Their first match will be against Moscow Red Legion.
They were beating us. We got a major penalty, and then Yosh and Dalton were able to just like sit there and zone off the field and hide.
When the situation came up that it was 2-on-4 and we were trapped in that Dorito corner, I think people kind of wrote it off, like, okay, whatever, that one's done. We need to go back out there and burn the penalty off for the next point. And when the game started to get prolonged, Dalton shot a guy, you know, their guys started moving slower, it looked like they were confused. I think the pit started feeling like, holy shit, this is actually happening. You know, this is really cool. We've been playing this long 2-on-2 now, and they were basically at 90-degree angles from us. I felt like at that point one of us should have gotten shot, but I hadn't looked the snake way for such a long time that when I finally did look that way, I caught the guy off guard. I made a move right then thinking that I had scared him enough where he wasn't going to peek out. And when I got to him, he didn't have his gun up. He didn't look like he was communicating. And so I got to bunker him, and then it was 2-on-1, and things just fell our way after that. It was kind of comical, actually.
Get him, boys! That's what's up, man! Good game! Let's go, man!
I just asked guys to play hard the whole time, and those guys did what I asked. They played with grit, and they just played through that extremely tough point. But for the other guys, it showed them, hey, you know, don't ever surrender out there. If you just hang in, you can win points. So then it went point for point after that, you know. We went out, won a point, they won a point, we went back and forth.
Let's go, baby, great! It ain't gonna be easy, Dynasty! One and more!
Game up in a fast point, and then we had to play him in overtime.
Whenever you're walking off the field and you hear another dead guy talking, someone eliminated like that, for instance, and you're also eliminated, the first thing I want to do is go, hey, did you hear him? Ref, did you hear what he said? You know, but you can't do anything. So luckily the refs caught on that.
You guys got another chance to win this point for us, baby. Let's go.
After a nail-biter with the Russians, Dynasty comes out victorious. Their next match will be against the only team that beat them in the Dallas event, Houston Heat.
Hey, we have to bring it
back.
Let's go.
Come on, every game is the fucking final.
Hey, there's no doubt in my mind, motherfuckers, all right?
This is
you guys know this shit, all right?
Let's go.
We go out and play like we know how to play, all right? Yep. It's that simple.
D-Y-N-A-S-T!
It's us, baby. Let's go.
Let's
do it. True.
Yeah,
1, 2, 3.
Team!
Game time!
I like playing them because it's kind of a smash 'em, crash 'em, and smart paintball game at the same time. So they were kind of built to beat us, and I like matching them because I like beating them.
Any match that we play against Heat is always a grinder. This was no different. We tried to employ our slow, boring strategy, and you know, sometimes you lose gunfights, sometimes you get shot off the break, and that's how they were able to break us down a couple times. When Glenn got the penalty, I don't think anyone on our team felt that it was justified. And I think it kind of fired people up. It was like, hey, we didn't deserve that. Glenn didn't deserve that. Let's go out and get this point for Glenn. Let's go out and get this point for Rusty, because Rusty shouldn't be in this situation. We all shouldn't be in this situation. Let's go out there and get it.
brother watches all the matches, and he texts me during the match, and he's like, I'd like to say the penalties are hurting you, but it's actually making people play more controlled and tighter. The penalty kind of like made us realize, hey, we can still do well with just controlling the field how we want to control it.
Hey, Dynasty, listen. We won that 3 bodies up, 3-on-5. If we have 5 bodies, ain't fucking chance in the day. Let's go.
I was running 2 lines, and I had one line that was winning all their points, and I had another line that was losing points, but I believed the squad was good enough, and I didn't want to sit them out and run the other squad back to back. I just wanted them to fix themselves.
Hey, this line's 1 and 2. Let's figure it out.
Fuck, sack, fuck up.
But here's the turning point. I trust you, but make me fucking believe that I trust you. Okay. Let's go out and fucking play. Every point's brand fucking new.
What's happening on it? How can I help you get out there?
I mean, I got shot at the break.
Why don't we hold it back then?
Okay, what we can do is he goes into the Utah, shoots straight ahead, and dives across.
Yo, she's got bounce going to
Utah. So the back center.
Yo, she's got bounce going to Utah.
Okay.
Let me go to California, dude.
I got bounced twice in the stomach.
Yeah.
And I felt like I didn't shoot.
Okay, then how about we go all over?
I'll just go to California.
Okay.
We had good control on the field. We were in the right spots. And then for some reason, Blake Yarber had like a little bit of a brain fart. I don't know if the grass was high and he thought he was in the woods, but he was like crawling around over there and then just got caught with his pants down. Once he died, that broke that side and their push came through that side. When they lost that and they knew they were down and they lost that point, I think they took it upon themselves to know that they owed me for the rest of the tournament.
Come on, man! We gotta play to win this point! We're better than that, man!
We are, dude.
We are so much better than that, dude!
Me watching that happen, I felt like we had all let all of it down. You see a guy get bunkered, or you see a squad lose a point, I feel like we're letting that guy down if we don't go out and get the next point, or we don't go out and win the match. So the mentality going into the next point was do everything you can, you know? You gotta fight. Grit is what is gonna win this game, and that's what we went with.
Hey, turn that line. We're turning that line. Hey, Dahl, you're turning. Come in.
You guys got the heat, baby.
No, hey, yo, you're turning.
We knew what their game plan was. In the last 30 seconds, they have to score a point. So the biggest thing that's going through your head is don't get a penalty and don't let them score the point.
Coming through, and then Yosh was just handling people. He got out to the corner and was just shot this guy coming through, wrapped around, shot Fedorov like 10 feet away from him, shot another guy, and put it into him.
Yeah, baby! Yeah, baby! You're the fucking man, baby! You came to play! Don't you round, you came to play, baby!
Do you want any answer?
What? Hey, no game is easy, man! No game is easy! Yeah, baby! Yeah,
let's go!
Let's go, baby.
Let's go.
Hey, grit, man. Grit. Five guys. That's all we need.
Hey, honestly, we won those 2 games. I'm very fucking happy. But this team, we can play a lot better.
So much better.
We got to play better.
I'm so proud to see that. Those grit games, dude. And have people have those games to pull off, you know?
Let's go, man.
But honestly, at the end of the day, dude, we got to fucking play all of us good across the board. And then all these games will be fucking 5 up.
It's this right here. This
togetherness.
This togetherness. This is what we keep.
Look at our hands together, baby.
All right, let's get more focus. Let's fix our shit. All right, let's go watch Iron Man.
And we'll buffer.
Buffering tonight.
No buffering.
1, 2, 3.
Team! D-Y-N-A-S-T!
What?
Playing against CEP in the prelims was pretty typical, honestly.
In this bracket, 2 teams move on. That means someone's going home that probably could end up with a 3-1. So we had to come out and smash them to secure our spot to play in the final round. So sorry to whoever that we got to play, but we're coming in full intensity.
The game that we played against Impact in the prelims was kind of a pointless game because both of us had already determined that we were going to move on. I'm not really sure what their mentality was going into it, but our mentality was we may have to play these guys again on Sunday, so let's beat the shit out of them.
We knew their game plan. We knew what they were going to do, how they were going to do it, and they played into us. It was great.
In the Impact match, penalties were a huge factor, but I think that the reason they got those penalties was because they were frustrated. I think they felt like anything they were trying wasn't working, and so they started playing on those, you know, outer areas of the gray area, and they got rolled up for it.
Once we figured out, okay, we're playing the Ironman, so I was like, all right, that's interesting because they just pummeled us last weekend. So now let's show these guys what we learned on the field.
We love this shit. This is what we live for, yeah. All right? This is Sunday Dynasty Paintball, all right? It's our time to shine.
Let's go.
Every single one of you guys, let's win.
I got
let's
one
go.
Fucking word, baby.
Fucking grit.
Grit.
Let's go. One, two, three.
Grit.
Had this one game plan that we liked, and it was get to your spots alive, lock it up. If we get up two bodies, then we can start pushing into them and start bunkering guys. And we just kept doing it, and it just kept working. We were kind of waiting for someone to be like, nope, this isn't going to work. This is what we're doing to stop it. Now you got to come up with something else, and it just never really happened. Two points. It felt like our game plan was still working. It felt like they hadn't learned anything from practice. And it also felt like they hadn't figured out what we were doing for the tournament up to that point. So there was a massive major penalty bomb.
They were in the 50 Dorito, and I think Alex went and bunkered him out of the 50 Dorito. Mike blew the horn when that happened. So the game was over. Well, the ref still went and threw a penalty flag on Alex for bunkering him. So the kid in the 50 Dorito saw the penalty flag go and goes, oh, the game's still on. So runs and grabs the flag, and I'm sitting there watching the thing go down.
You're in a game, and some guy's running around like it's a live game. It's like you got to put paint on the guy to make sure he's dead. They shoot him, he shoots back. Mouse shoots someone, and all, I don't know, everyone started shooting people.
Oh, they blew the horn!
They blew the horn!
They blew the horn!
Trade it with the guy! And then one ref was like,
it's fine.
Trade out, and then Tony threw a red flag.
Hey, just stay composed, it's okay.
Make sure you're ready to go in the box just in case. You know, get your shit, get out there just in case.
Luckily, they penalized the Ironman for the same thing they penalized us for, because we had to run over there in the ref powwow, and they were trying just to give us penalties. But, you know, justice prevailed. And we were all serving time for the same crimes.
Result was we ended up with two major penalties out of that. We already had the one from Alex. They ended up with two major penalties, so we had to break out 3-on-2. First point out, I used Brandon and Glenn, and we had a code for where their guy was going to shoot on the break. So we yelled yellow, which was the guy who was going to shoot snake side. So Brandon knew the guy was going to shoot at him, which means he should have ran out there, dove into his spot. Well, he went out shooting back, you know, kind of didn't get a good read on the call and got shot right in the face. Well, now it's 3-on-1 and those guys come down and they're on a time mission because they got to try and rack as many points while we're playing 3-on-2. If they can shoot a guy on the break, that's their ultimate goal. They run down, bunker Glenn, hang the flag.
And I, we hauled out to our spots. I shot Marcelo kind of getting lazy up the center, and then Steven came over and bunkered Yosh. I think actually Yosh might have shot the snake eye before he got bunkered, and then Steven kind of lost track of me.
and I was able to shoot him out. That was a huge boost for our team.
Hey, 21 seconds, a train is coming out of each end.
The game was about to start and our pit side was saying, you know, in 21 seconds, everyone's coming out of there. Just keep that in mind. So the breakout happens and I shoot Steven Pitts off the break and I wrap and I think I shoot Marcelo, and what I thought was a G wasn't actually Marcelo. It slipped out to the Dorito side somehow. I felt like something weird happened there. It ended up shooting me and coming down the field. Right when I got shot, I looked back and all of our guys come piling out of the box, and it was one of the coolest things I've ever seen because it looked like an awesome coordinated attack, you know. And honestly, from that point on, the rest of that point was chaos.
Three of our guys run out, two of their guys run out. Bodies are falling down everywhere. Ryan ends up in a one-on-one, doesn't know where Mouse is, and gets shot. And that was their second point that they scored. Then after that, we went out and beat them on the next point and ended the match. It don't gotta be pretty. It just has to be a fucking win, that's all.
Hey, listen. I just want to let you know, we are the only motherfuckers that matter right here in this huddle. Everybody is against us.
I feel it, man.
That shit is crazy talk right there. But you know what? This is all that matters, all right?
Us.
Do this for us now. Yeah, we got one more goal, okay? And I'll tell you right now, we keep getting better.
It's fun to be dick.
We keep getting
fun
better.
Fun to be Let's go. Keep your face on. Keep your face on.
Ah. 1, 2, 3, 2. Pee-wee.
Everybody, one clap.
The finals at MAO, you know, playing against Tampa again. It actually felt like that's the matchup that we were looking for. They're always a great team to play against in the finals. They earned their spot there, but we were really confident in our game plan, in our single game plan.
I like that one.
Ah!
I love that one.
Okay.
There we go, man.
Yeah,
all day. All day. Let's go.
This is our shit right here, man.
Hey, it's our hour. It's our fucking time. Winning time. Let's go.
Hey, motherfuckers, you know what?
Everybody feels it.
Hey, nobody can fucking stop us.
We've talked enough. We know enough, okay?
That's
time
right.
to go out and fucking goddamn do it, okay?
That's right.
Enough
That's
shit right. said, all right?
No, leave it all out here.
D-Y-L-A-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-S-T-E-R-U-
team!
Playing against Tampa in the finals, the first point is always that kind of feel-out point. You know, you can expect it to go long. I think all of us probably brought more paint expecting it to be a long point. And I think that was probably the point that they learned their lesson. You know, they ended up trying to put together a push and got a couple guys shot out of their spots. And, you know, we ended up taking the point, and I think they realized from that point on that it was just going to be a really, really tough, methodical, slow game.
The second point, we came out there really confident after the first long point. You know, we knew that we can play their game, and we ended up shooting their entire Dorito side off the break, and Kevin immediately had to blow the horn, so now we were up 2-0. And then the next squad goes out, confident as hell, and we beat them up again, and Kevin concedes the third point.
We got a long game. Let's go. Finish out, man. Let's fucking push through every point.
Once we were up 3-0, the points kind of started, like, our back center guy should have gotten out of the back center. They moved, damage was moving all around their side of the field, trying to break the field down. Finally, they got in a position where another guy could help shoot the back center guy. So our back center guy was shooting at a guy, another guy came and shot him. And then that was able to break that side of the field there and push through at that. And that's when they scored the first point, is that really long point. But they figured out how to do it.
Tampa started to make their comeback and they scored those 2 points, they ended up trying to find these holes and team up on our guys that were just watching zones. And it was working, you know, but it was just one of those things that it just took so much time to put that together.
Ball one yoked. He didn't go to the queen until fucking
three minutes. What is that? Let's refill. Go back center, let's refill.
D1NASP!
I should have called the
center. D1NASP! Let's play, man.
That last point, it was like, get to your spot, play tight, and just flood these gaps with paint. Don't let them come onto our side of the field.
I was on the sidelines or in the pit watching the game and how tight our guys were playing over there. Brandon Short didn't even get shot. He just called himself out. And he's like, well, I saw the clock and I didn't want to like get a penalty just in case I did get shot or something. You know, it's nail biting, you know, watching, because I've seen us from the pits. I've been watching games when we've lost.
Feels good not to lose.
Hey, we're just getting fucking better as this game.
Hey, man. Hey,
they don't want it with us.
Listen.
Let's go.
Listen. The reason I want to play all the guys is because I want longevity and I want to have a long fucking winning situation, yes, man. Okay. All these other guys are fast burners because they burn their guys out. Yeah. We're fucking 10 strong and I love it, man.
Let's go.
And you know what, dude? Honestly, this is a fucking great tournament because we all played equal.
Everybody
fucking killed it. It was just everybody was there. Everybody was there when we needed them to be. And that was team, dude. I want a big ass fucking hug.
Let's get a hug in here, boys!
Guess what, boys? We got more to win. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
I think the reason that we're playing so well right now is because we've been humbled, you know? And because we're feeding off of that. We're feeding off of the idea that it's not right to go home on Saturday. You know, it's not right for us to lose early on Sunday. It doesn't feel good. It feels way better to work hard, work through the pain the weekends before, and go out and play strong at the tournament. And I think that's going to be our mentality going forward. I know teams are going to play us harder now. You know, everybody wants to knock you off when you're on the top. It's like that for any team. So there's no new swagger. Except for, you know, the grit at the beginning of the year is going to be our thing the whole time.
Did he miss anything that you noticed?
Drew down. More souvenirs, that's all.
We implemented a system where if the camera saw you get shot, you had to do push-ups. It had been a bad match for Dalton, and I think he might have gotten 6 student penalties too. So he was pretty much doing push-ups the entire time, but, you know, he's huge, so no worries.